We're asked to fill in the table with the missing function values, then determine if the table models a linear function or an exponential function. Where function values with a pattern of repeated addition represent a linear function, and function values with a pattern of repeated multiplication represent an exponential function. So looking at the first table, we have the inputs are x values, which increased by 2 each time. Now let's analyze the function values and see if we can recognize a pattern. The function values go from 8 to 4, and then 4 to 2. Well, let's say we recognize that 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4, and 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. By recognizing this pattern, we can now determine the missing function values here. Continuing the pattern, 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1, and 1 divided by 2 is equal to 0.5, or 1/2. But now to determine if we have a linear function or exponential function, we said an exponential function has a pattern of repeated multiplication, and we have a pattern of repeated division. But remember, we can always write division as multiplication by multiplying by the reciprocal. Dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of 2, and because as a fraction, 2 is 2 over 1, the reciprocal is 1/2, so the pattern can be expressed as repeated multiplication by multiplying by 1/2 each time. Again, multiplying by 1/2 is the same as dividing by 2. And therefore, f of x is an exponential function. Now let's look at the next table. Again, notice how the x values or inputs increase by 2 each time. Now let's analyze the function values. The function values go from 1 to negative 3 to negative 7. If we tried the pattern of repeated multiplication, 1 times negative 3 equals negative 3, but negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9, not negative 7. So we don't have a pattern of repeated multiplication, but let's say we do recognize that 1 minus 4 is equal to negative 3, and negative 3 minus 4 is equal to negative 7. By recognizing this pattern, we can now complete the table by continuing the pattern. Negative 7 minus 4 equals negative 11. Negative 11 minus 4 is equal to negative 15. But again, when we go to identify whether we have an exponential or linear function, function values with a pattern of repeated addition represent a linear function. And we have a pattern of repeated subtraction. Remember, a subtraction problem can always be written as an addition problem. Subtracting 4 is the same as adding negative 4. So we can also express the pattern as plus negative 4. So because the pattern can be expressed as repeated addition, we know g of x is a linear function. This is an important example to understand because we just discovered that if we recognize a pattern of repeated multiplication or division, we have an exponential function. And if we recognize a pattern of repeated addition or subtraction, we have a linear function. Before we go, let's look at f of x and g of x graphically by plotting several points of the functions on the same coordinate plane and then sketching a graph for f of x and g of x. If you were to plot the first three points of f of x on the coordinate plane, it would be these three points here. If we sketch the graph, it would form a curve. An exponential function is always going to be a curve. If we graph the first three points of g of x on the coordinate plane, it would be these three points here. Notice how the three points form a line, verifying g of x is a linear function. I hope you found this helpful.